So let's start PPT. So hello everyone, my name is Prathamesh Hiramat. I am from Vivekananda College, Kolhapur. So I am telling the PPT on human resource management. So let's start. So what are the objectives in this presentation? First one is concept, second definition, third function, and fourth challenges. So what is human? Human means people, you have already know that. And what is resource? A resource means it is a stock in which company will be maintained, and it is used in everything to achieve goal or function effectively. In this resource, all type of asset will come, like human asset, monetary asset, etc. And what is management? Management defines as all the activities and tasks undertaken for achieving goals by continuous activities like planning, organizing, leading, and controlling. So HRM is the process in which human resource of efficient and effective is used to achieve the goal. So by combination of all three, so let's start. What is human resource management? In simple words, human resource management is a process of making the efficient and effective use of human resource so that the set goals are achieved. Means HRM is a process in which human resource of efficient and effective is used to achieve the goal. So let's start the functions of human resource management. It can be divided into three categories: managerial function, operative function, and advisory function. So let's start in detail. So first one is managerial function. Managerial function are the primary function. All the managers have to do this, like HR manager, business manager, operator manager, etc. So it can be divided into four categories: planning, organizing, directing, and controlling. So first one is planning. It is deciding in advance that what to do and how to do. Next is organizing. In this, work will be differentiated upon employees and it will be arranged among group members. Next, directing. In this, we have to direct or motivate to employees to achieve the goal. Fourth one is controlling. It means to check the errors and to take the corrective actions. And next is operative function. It is a day-to-day functions, working function, and it is core functions. So it can be divided into again four categories. First one is procurement. Procurement means it is a process of obtaining something. What we have to obtain to do the work for organization, like workforce, employees, and all requirements are come under these functions. Next is development. In this, training, career planning, career development, performance appraisal, potential appraisal, successive planning will come. And next is compensation. In this, compensation management, incentive benefit, work scheduling, job design is come. Means when employees will do work, he or she will need some compensation and types of needs, and also need motivation for do work. And next is maintenance. In this, we have to take care of employees about health, safety, and welfare to do efficient and effective work. Next is advisory function. In this, there are two levels. First one is at top level management. Managers will give the advices at top level management, like policies, procedures, etc. And next is at department level. In this also, he or she will give advices at this level to run smoothly operations. Next is, what are the challenges of human resource management? First one is attracting top talent. To select the best talent, take judgment, time, and whole lot of work. That's why this human resource challenges features are upon still this list. Next is requirement and selection. Finding a suitable candidate for this job from a large number of applications is a basic problem for the human resource manager. They have to make suitable changes from time to time in this selection procedure and see it to that candidate is up to make fulfilling the job requirement. Next is balance between management and employees. In this, the human resource manager has a responsibility to balance the interest of management and employees. Profits, commitment, cooperation, loyalty are the factors expected by the management. Next is training, development, and compensation. A planned execution of training programs and manager development program is required to be undertaken to sharpen and enhance skill and to develop knowledge of employees. Compensation is a form of salary, bonus, allowances is to be paid according to the performance of the people. And next is performance appraisal. This activity should not be considered a routine process by the human resource manager. If employees are not getting proper feedback from them, it may affect their future work. A scientific appraisal techniques according to the changing need should be applied, and the quantity of it should be checked from time to time. Thank you.